Okay, now we need to assign spandrel labels for coupling beams. Setting the plan view in order to check the grid system, we can see that we need to set it on elevation of grid E because we can here view the coupling beam. Therefore, going to G2E, and if we count the coupling beams, we have 8 coupling beams in this core, and here we have also 8, therefore the total is 16. We need to go to the define spandrel labels, and I have already defined 16 spandrels. We need just now to zoom in here a little bit, selecting all of those segments of the coupling beam and going to the assign shell spandrel label, and this is S1. The above one is S2, and we need just to follow the same order. But before proceeding, let me show you this example I have prepared before recording this video. I have used two ways of assigning spandrels for coupling beam. The first one, I have tried to assign the same spandrel for all segments of this coupling beam. While for the second way, I have used several spandrels and I have assigned them as shown in this photo. And as a result, after I have run the analysis, I have checked the bending moment due to lateral force applied in the X direction, and as shown, we can see that the correct way of modeling coupling beam is to assign the same spandrel for all segments, because this is the correct and the normal bending moment that we can expect as a structural engineers, while the above diagram have a lot of discontinuity. It have this zigzag shape, let's say there is something wrong in force transfer. Therefore, the correct way of modeling coupling beam is to assign the same spandrel for all segments. And this is not actually true for all ETABS version. I'm using ETABS 18.0.2. I think in the older version, the correct way of modeling spandrels is to assign many spandrels for the same coupling beam. Okay, therefore it depends. You need to check it by yourself to check what ETABS version you are using and which way is the correct way of modeling coupling beams. And now we need just to assign the rest of spandrels for those coupling beams. I will stop the recording screen a little bit. Okay, I have finished assigning the spandrel labels for all coupling beams in this model, as shown here and here. And as the name of coupling beam reveals, it couples two wall segments together, and it is especially used where there is an area opening like a door or a window. Putting the 3D view, we can see that we have even windows at this side. Therefore, setting the elevation view to this side at a grid B, we can see that those portions of the wall are coupling the wall segment of this side and this side. Therefore, we can consider even this wall segment to be a coupling beam. But the main difference is that this is called a squat wall because it have an aspect ratio of length divided by height equal to 1, and it is even less than 1, I think, in this situation. But if you check the coupling beam above the door, we can find that the aspect ratio of lengths divided by height is higher than 1, or even it is greater than 2. Actually, I'm mentioning the ratio of those beams because this ratio could provide some kind of information about the response actually of those components. Beams with higher aspect ratio tend to be more flexible, resulting in lower flexural stiffness compared to those with lower aspect ratios. Therefore, we can generally say that coupling beams with high aspect ratios may fail due to flexural behavior. Therefore, we can expect to have plastic hinges at the ends of this beam under earthquake load, okay? While walls with low aspect ratio may fail due to shear behavior. This is actually the main difference in response of those two components, okay? The last thing I want to mention about those segments, if we want to assign spandrel labels for them, and I will do that actually, we need to go to define spandrel labels. I will provide a new name called MS1. I will add one, and for that I will select it again, and I will check here the multi-story option. Okay, and okay. Okay, why I need to use this multi-story option? If the height of the coupling beam exceeds half of the story height, therefore we need to use the multi-story option shown here. Because if we assign a spandrel label for this portion without checking this multi-story option, we will get actually two bending diagram, because ETABS can assume that this portion is divided into two parts or into two stories actually, because the height of this wall segments exceed half of the story height, okay? If the height of this wall segment doesn't exceed the half of the story height, then we can just ignore this option here and just we need to do it as we have did it before, okay? Therefore, we need to assign MS1 for this portion, going to the assign shell spandrel label, and we need to use MS1. And now, before proceeding, let me show you this example also that I have created before recording this video. As shown here, I have used the same spandrel label for this portion, while I have used different spandrel label for each vertical segment, and actually both are correct. If you can see here, the bending moment diagram due to dead loads or the self weights, it just have the normal shape. The only difference that we have here, more data at each joint, okay? Similarly, if we check the shear diagram for those portions due to self weight, also we can notice that the shear diagram is correct for both options. Due to lateral force applied in the X direction, this is the shear diagram, both are correct. And the bending moment also, it is the normal shape of bending moment for those portions. Therefore, we can use this option or this option. It depends if you want more data. If you want more data at each station, we need to assign different spandrels as shown here. But if we are just sure about that the maximum results are located at the ends, let's say, we can just use one spandrel, and we need to select the multi-story option if the height of this portion of the wall segments exceeds the half of the story height. Okay, let's now define the remaining spandrels, and we need to add up to 12 spandrels for those stiff coupling beams. Also, we need to check this option, the multi-story option. After adding the spandrel label that is already defined, we need to select it again, and we need to check this option here, okay? In this way. Okay, now we have defined all the spandrels with the multi-story option. We need to come here to select those segments of the coupling beam and go to the spandrel label. And this is MS2. I'm providing the M letter at the beginning to make it easy to recognize that I'm using the multi-story options for those spandrel labels, okay? Now we need just to do the same for this score. We need to start here from the 7. MS7. Okay, after we have finished assigning the spandrel labels, we need just to define the diaphragm. And by default, there is an existing diaphragm already defined inside ETABS. This is a rigid diaphragm actually, and we need to use a rigid diaphragm for this model. I will go to the select option. I will select all the floors. Then I will go to the assigned shell diaphragms, and this is D1. Okay. Now let's hide the diaphragm extension. Also, we need to disable the spandrel label from here, from the set display option. And lastly, let's go to the base to assign a new fixed support for the new created joints by selecting all the joints and going to the assign joint restraint. And let's select the first option, which is the fixed support, and apply. Now we can see that all the joints have the fixed support. Let's save this model. And please continue watching my next video.